नियतिकृतनियमरहितां क्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि बीन् लुकिङ्ग् एट् वाक्यमात्रदोषाः. वि हव् सीन् एय्ट् आफ् दोस् दोषास् फार् नौ अण्टिल् कथितपदत्वं. विल् हाव् टु लुक् एट् पतत् प्रकर्षम्. शो द टेक्स्ट्. पतत् प्रकर्षं मीन्स् पतत् प्रकर्षः उत्कर्षः यत्र वाक्ये दट् इस् काल्ड् पतत् प्रकर्षं. पतत् पतन् प्रकर्षः. सो द प्रकर्षः और् उत्कर्षः वेर् दि ऐडिया अर्थं गिवेन् फ्रम् दि अर्थं दट् वि नो फ्रम् द वाक्यं स्टार्ट्स् आफ् वित् अ वेरि इम्प्रेसिव् बिगिनिङ्ग् एण्ड् देन् स्लोलि इट् जस्ट् कम्स् डौन्. Where you lose that force of expression, then it is called a patat prakarsham. Like any work, you always start off enthusiastically and then slowly as it goes, the number of people who join it slowly becomes less. All the participation will become less. We've seen that many times. So it is something like that, similar to that. So in this shloka, it's a four line shloka where the first three are it gives out a very prakarsha utkarsha artham, and the last line it just slows down the beauty. The example here is, so kaha kaha kutrana ghurghurayita ghuri ghoraha ghuret sukaraha kaha kaha kam kamalakaram vikamalam kartum kari nodyataha keke kani vanani aranya mahisha न उन्मूलयेयुः यतः सिंहि स्नेह विलास बद्ध वसतिः पञ्चाननो वर्तते. सो यतः द फैक्ट दैट बिकॉज वेन द लायन, सो द हियर द लायन इज द किंग ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट. सो वेन ही इज एक्टिव एंड रोमिंग अराउंड ऑल ऑफ द एनिमल्स आर क्वाइट. सो दे डोंट वांट टू शो देयर फेसेस बिकॉज दे the lion might pounce on them and they will become a prey to the lion. So every animal which is quiet now is showing off its face because the lion is bound by the love that the lioness is showing. So simhi sneha vilasa baddha vasatihi, his vasati, he is staying baddham, or his vilas, the he baddha vasati, he means his stay is confined by the vilasam, the beauty or the graces that is involved in the simhi sneha, the love shown by the lioness. So the lioness is showing her love and the lion is bound by that and he is just staying. So panchananaha vartate. Panchananaha means pancha vistritam ananam yasya, pancha ananam, not five faces. So the lion is now bound by the love of the simhi. Hence, what is happening? Kaha kaha sukaraha na ghuret, which boar will not make a sound. So the boars are now, because the lion is quietly sitting with the lioness, the boar is roaming around making a ghur ghur sound. Ghur ghur ayita ghuri nasa, ghuri is nasa, ghoraha भयङ्करः सूकरः कः कः सूकरः विच् सूकर एव्री स्माल् स्माल् बोर् विच् इस् देर् आल् दट् इस् नौ रन्निङ्ग् अराउण्ड् मेकिङ्ग् अ नाय्स् वित् इट्स् दट् स्नार्टिङ्ग् नाय्स् वित् इट्स् स्नार्ट् वित् इट्स् नोस् कुत्र कुत्र एव्रिवेर् वेर् एण्ड् आल् इट् सी प्लेसेस् वेर् इट् वुड् नाट् इवन् गान् बिफोर् वेर् द लयन् वुड् हव् कम् देर् इट् इस् नौ रोमिङ्ग् अराउण्ड् बिकास् इट्स् वेरि शुर् देट् दिस् लयन् इस् with the simhi, with the lioness, and so he has no issues about it. So kaha kaha sukaraha kutra gurgurayita ghuri ghoraha sanna na ghuret. Gurgurayita is an onomatopoeic word. It's a the sound, it's the sound that is produced by the boar. Next, kaha kaha kari, which elephant will not be employed, or which elephant will not destroy the lotus ponds. So the elephant is also now very confident that the lion will not attack. So he is also roaming around near the lotus ponds. Kamalakaram vikamalam kartum, कहा कहा करी विच एलिफेंट कम कमलाकरं विकमलं कर्तुं न उद्यतः विच एलिफेंट विल नॉट मेक एन एफर्ट न उद्यतः टू डिस्ट्रॉय विकमलं कर्तुं टू मेक ए लोटस पॉन्ड डिवॉइड ऑफ लोटसेस विकमलं कर्तुं कमल विगतं कर्तुं तडागं कः न उद्यतः भवति कः गजः उद्यतः न भवति सर्वे अपि बिकॉज द सिंहः इज लाइंग डाउन क्वाइटली के के कानि वनानि अरण्यमहिषाः के के अरण्यमहिषाः कानि कानि वनानि न उन्मूलयेयुः उन्मूलयेयुः अप्रूट् विच बफलो विल नॉट अप्रूट द फॉरेस्ट दट आर देर इट विल जस्ट रोम अराउंड Simhi Sneha Vilasa Baddha Vasatihi Panchanano Vartate. Now when I explained, I started off with the Simhi Sneham. If you look at the shloka's format, the first three show a prakarsham. The first three have a show. If he had explained in the manner that, you know, something like a simha, as an adjective for the simha, instead of simhi sneha vilasa baddha vasatihi, if he had said that the one who destroys all of these or the one who performs a greater destruction than all the above three is absent or is not present here. Something like that would have given, would have maintained that expression of excitement in that shloka. So the first three shows a raudram or you know, the destruction that is caused by these animals. And if the last line also had shown that, you know, the lion which is capable of ruling over the entire forest is not there. Then, or is sleeping, something like that. Or is with the simhi, something. You have to have had a visheshana which would have shown the Utkarsham, or if it would, it should have been much more Utkrishtataya Vartitavya. Otherwise, the Chamatkara is lost. So, the Prakarsham, the Utkarsha that is there in the first three lines is Patati. Patati means it is falling down in the sense there is a lessening of that Utkarsha in the last line. This is Patat Prakarsham for you. The next is Samapta Punaratam. Samapta Punarartham, something that is finished, you are again taking it up. Samaptam yat saha punaha aptam punaha upattam iti visheshana ubhayapadaha. So there are two visheshanas for this dosha. One is samaptam and at the same time punaha upattam cha. So samapta punarattam, aptam upattam both mean the same. So the meaning here is, the shloka is krenkaraha smarakarmukasya suratakrida vikinam ravaha jhankaro rati manjari madulyam leela chakori dvanihi tanvyaha kanchulika apasarana bhuja kshepa skhalat kankana kwanaf prema tanotuvo nava vayo lasyaya venuswanaha. The meaning, let's look at the meaning of the shloka. Here, kwanaha, tanvyaha, kanchulika, apasarana, bhuja, akshepa, skhalat, kankana, kwanaha, prema, tanotu. Let the, you know, there is a lady who is, or there are, it is about someone who is a kavi who is talking to those travelers who are going to go and meet their lovers. They are going back home. So there are a lot of travelers who have come for business and they are going to go back. A kavi is addressing them and saying, you know, tanvyaha kankanakwanaha vaha prema tanotu. That's the main sentence here. Tanvyaha, the ladies, kankanakwanaha, the sound of her bangles, vaha prema tanotu. Let it increase your love. The love that you have, or the rati, the sentiment that you have in your mind, let the lady's bangle sound increase it. So the bangle sound, what is that bangle sound? Not, he is alluding to the enjoyment that they are going to have with their respective beloveds when they go back home. by saying kanchulika apasarana bhuja akshepa skhalat kankana kwanaha. So when she is removing her blouse, kanchulika apasarana bhuja akshepa, when her hands are moving, tata tat samaye skhalat kankanam, the bangles will keep moving up and down on her hand, and that sound should increase your love. So he is alluding to that union that they are going to enjoy, the rati and the suratam that they are going to enjoy. So that kwanaha, he gives five rupakam for that. Everything else he is doing an rupaka alankara here by saying it is just like, it is the sound of Manmatha's bow. Smara karmukasya krenkaraha saha kankana kwanaha. Krenkaraha is a type of sound, that the twang of a bow, we say, right? So in that manner, here smara karmukasya krenkaraha, the sound that it is the same as it is like the sound of smara karmuka, Manmatha's bow. Surata krida piki nam ravaha, it is the sound that comes from piki, female parrots, which are involved in that surata krida, in that love making. So it is like the cooing of pikaha is cuckoo, not parrots. It's the sound of the female cuckoo, which during the love making, surata krida piki nam ravaha, rati manjari maduliham jhankaraha, rati manjari maduliham, madulihaha bees. Maduliham jhankaraha, it is the humming of the bees. What are the bees doing? They are surrounding the flowers because they love the flowers. Rati manjari, either the bees are in the process of, they are making love to each other, or during that time, how they keep surrounding the, the way they make love to that flowers, they come close to that flowers and, be with them and take the madhu from it. That way, they are showing, expressing their love, rati, manjari, towards the manjari, the flower, bunches of flowers. So that bees humming, jhankaraha. So rati, manjarishu, ratim, prakashayatam, madhuliham, jhankaraha. Next is, leela chakori dhvanihi. When the chakori, chakori is a type of like a pigeon or a partridge. It's a type of bird. When that bird is making a very leela sound, when she is trying to express her love to her beloved, the chakora pakshi, when it makes a sound during that love making, this is equal to that sound. So tandyaha kanchulika apasarana bhuja akshepa skhalat kankana kwanaha tava prema tanotu. Another word also he includes, which is nava vayo lasyaya venuswanaha yatha bhavati tatha kankana kwanaha api bhavati. So that kankana kwana is also, the fifth one he says is venu nava vayo lasyaya venuswanaha. It is the flute sound for the dance of the youth. So when a dance has to happen, just as how the flute sound comes before. Even in, if you go and see in today's Arangetram performances, or even Bharatanatyam, any dance performances, the music first starts off, and they always start off with the flute sound. So the flute sound comes before, and the moment the flute sound starts, everybody in the audience will keep quiet immediately. So until then, they will all be socializing and talking to each other. Suddenly, the flute will start off on ragam, and then everybody will be quiet and assemble down, because they know that it is a precursor for the dance. The same way here also, lasyam. Lasyam is a softer type of dance. Lasyam and tandavam are two types of dance. Tandavam is the more forceful dance that a man adopts, whereas the lasyam is the graceful type which a female adopts. So that here is used as, he says it is the nava vaya, vayaha lasyaya. Nava vayaha eva lasyam atra, which means the youth is the dance here. And for that dance, you need a venuswana, the flute sound. And this kankana kwanam is like that. So tadrishaha kankana kwanaha vaha yushmakam prema tanotu. Let it increase your prema. Here, let's, shloka is fine. Now let's go to the dosham. there are five rupakas that are given there for the kankana kwana. What are those? Krenkaraha, ravaha, jhankaraha, chakori dvanihi, venuswanaha, venuswanaha. All of these are actually rupakam for the kankana kwana. And that kankana kwana is the main object, main subject of this sentence. What the way he has arranged the shloka is, he has finished the sentence with prema tanotu vo, and then he brings up the another adjective or another rupakam at the end, and punaha aptam tat. What happens here? So the meaning here is samaptam sat punaraptam punarupaptam kriya karaka anvayena vakye samapte sati. When the sentence is completed with the kriya and karaka anvayam, you have all that, right? What is the kriya? Tanotu. Kim tanotu? Prema tanotu. Kaha tanotu? Kankana kwanaha prema tanotu. Kesham prema tanotu? Vaha prema tanotu. All these, you do that kriya karaka anvayam and you do that vakya samapti. After doing that, all of that, you suddenly find that there is an extra adjective there. Oh, I forgot about this adjective. What do I do with this? Oh, this also has to fit here. It is like an afterthought that it has come about. Huh? See, the kankana kwana can come at the end. Then it is fine. If the visheshya is mentioned at the end, then you have all the adjectives in one place. You have the kriya and then you have the visheshyam there. Now what happens is, he has four adjectives here. He has the visheshyam, then the kriya, then suddenly there should be some reasoning for another extra padam there. If there is a reasoning, then it's okay. Like, for example, maybe you can say this. What is that? Machitte sti trilochanaha. Tapam haratu vashivaha. No. Sudamshu kalitottam saha, tapam haratu vashivaha. So if we say tapam haratu vashivaha, sudamshu kalitottam saha, if we rearrange the whole sentence like this, let's say that it was like this, tapam haratu vashivaha, sudamshu kalitottam saha. Or the idea is, if there is a visheshanam given at the end, that should actually be used as a special qualifier. If such a speciality is absent in it, then there is no point. Which means, then it is a samapta punaratattvam doshaha. You get it? So, kriya karaka anvayena samapte sati punaha tadvakya anvayinaha padasya abhidanam vina visheshanam vina vishesha pratipattihi. You can say, so without any specific knowledge or without adding any speciality towards the whole sentence, it is just another rupakam that is given. It's as if it only shows the poet's inability. So actually, interestingly, I was just looking at Dhanyalokam. In the third Udyota, he says, doshas can be of only two types. One is vyutpatti rahityatvadu, athava shakti rahityatvadu. If the poet has no vyutpatti, then there is a problem. Or if the poet has no creativity, then there is a problem. That's all there is. So each one of these doshas can be put into under those two categories very easily. So dosha are just of two types. That is the same thing that is expressed in Auchityam also, where he says Auchityam, Anauchityam. If it is appropriate, then it is a rasa. If it is dosham, then if it is Anauchityam, then you can put it in any of the categories of dosha that you say. There are some 60-70 doshas that you are saying. Whatever it may be, it doesn't matter. So all these are just revealing the ineptness of a kavi, inability of a kavi. That's all. So next one is, 1 minute, let me look at the text. Samapta punaraptam is over. Next is dvitiyardha gata ekavachaka shesha prathamardham. Actually, the this thing is ardhantara ekavachakam is the one that is given as the dosha, the name of the dosha. He explains what the name of the dosha is with this dvitiyardha gata ekavachaka शेष प्रथमार्धं यथा. सो द प्रथमार्धं शेषं शिष्टम् अस्ति, अवशिष्टम् अस्ति तत्र प्रथमार्धे. देन् यु गो टु द द्वितीयार्धं फार् जस्ट् वन् वाचकशब्दं. देर् इस् जस्ट् वन् पदं दट् हेस् தமிழ்ல அழகா வரும், ஒரு ஒரு பதம் போய் ரெண்டாவதுல மாட்டின் இருக்கு நமக்கு. அதனால இங்க ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பதம் இஸ் அ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஹாஃப் இஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம். தட் இஸ் இட் இஸ் கான் அண்ட் லாக்ட் இட் செல்ஃப் இன் த செகண்ட் பாதம், செகண்ட் ஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த ஸ்லோகா, விச் இஸ் நீடட் ஃபார் தி எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் ஆஃப் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த ஸ்லோகம். இட்ஸ் ஆல் ரைட், you know, you can say in a poetry the words can be wherever you want, there is no syntax. All these occurs because of that syntax problem. Even with no syntax as a big tag in Sanskritam, we still have so many doshas. It means there is some sort of a syntax is expected in Sanskritam, right? Otherwise, you will not have something like Tvam Kim Pibasi or Tvam Pibasi Kim. There is a difference between the two of them. When I say Tvam Kim Pibasi, what are you drinking? When I say Tvam Pibasi Kim, are you drinking something? No, there is a difference. There is a syntax in Sanskritam. So you need the placement of words is absolutely necessary for a shloka also. So here, dvitiyardha gata ekavachaka shesha prathamardham. Meaning of that is, yatra prathamardha gatam vakyam, dvitiyardha gata ekavachaka. Vachakam is always shabdam or padam. So ekena padena puryate. The pratamardham puryate, pratamardhagatam vakyam puryate. Now let's look at the shlokam. The masrana charanapadam gamyatam bhusadarbha virachaya sachayantam murdhri dharmah katoraha taditi janakaputri lochanai rashrupurnaihi padipadika vadubihi vikshita shikshita cha. Look at the context of this shloka. Balaramayanam. What I was thinking about. It's Rajashekara Krita Balaramayane Shashthe Anke Ramena Saha Vanavasam Gatayam Sitayam Tadvartham Kathayataha Dasharatham Dasharatha Amatyasya Sumantrasya Dasharatham Prati Uktihi. So the context here is Ramena Saha Vanavasam Gatayam Sitayam. With Rama, Sita has gone to the Vanavasa. Sumantra, see, Sumantra followed them until a certain step, right? Till a point, nobody else followed them until that stage. So Sumantra followed them the maximum. So he says, Tadvartam katayataha dasharatha, dasharatha amatyasya sumantrasya dasharatham prati. So he was conveying the whole matter. So Dasharatha was so curious, what happened to them? I just sent them to the Vanavasa, how were they? Just tell me, give me some news. So Dasharatha was asking Sumantra, and Sumantra was giving him a reply. He was talking about the how Sita was walking and what the, you know, the people who were all nearby. Pathika vadu vihi pathi sa vikshita ka janakaputri vikshita. He points out very beautifully. He says, janakaputri, see, you had no right to banish her. Okay, that is too strong. But he still says she is Janaka's daughter. How can you do it for her? You know, Janaka Putri sa, and she's not some commoner whom Rama has married. She has also been raised as a princess. So Janaka Putri sa, bhavat snushacha, just indicates that, no, you may not, you can send your daughter-in-law, but you could have at least considered that she is someone else's daughter. And thought about it. So he says, Janaka Putri sa pathi, on the way. There were a lot of these travelers who were traveling with their wives, or the Maharshis whom they encountered, and their wives were also there. So pathika vadu bihi, those who were all on the road. They were, see, right from the time they left the palace, they did not go in the moment Kaikeyi said go, Vanavasam. He did not want any of those, and he stepped out on foot. So he did not go by the ratham. So as they were walking on foot, they must have crossed small, small suburbs and then went to the forest. It is not that the forest is immediately from the gates of the Nagaram. So there must have been the Nagaram. There were people on the streets of the Nagaram, the suburbs also. Imagine all that. So Pathika Vadu Bihi, by those people who are all standing there, Pathikaha Tesham Vadu Bihi, Vikshita Janakaputri, Katham Vikshita, Lochanaihi, Ashrupurnaihi Vikshita, Ashrupurnaihi Lochanaihi. Their eyes were filled with tears and they were looking at her. Ashrupurnaihi Lochanaihi Vikshita Sa. So what happened is, Janakaputri, Ashrupurnaihi Lochanaihi Vikshita, Shikshita Cha. Another thing he says, they also said something to her. What did they say? Masrina charana patam gamyatam bhus sadarbha. Bhuhu sadarbha darbhankura yukta asti bhuhu bhuvihi darbaihi yukta asti. So there are a lot of darbha grass, kusha grass on the floor. So masrina charana patam gamyatam. Don't keep your legs forcefully. Keep it very softly. Charana patam masrinam yatha syat tatha kriyatam. So keep your feet very softly on that. So tate, so I've underlined that here. Take that word for that. Tate ityukte tasmat karanat. Bhuhu sadarbha asti. Dharvankura yukta asti bhumihi. Tate tasmat karanat. Masrana charanapatam gamyatam. Place your feet very softly. She doesn't know. She's never traveled on foot on places where there is darbhagras. So they are advising her. Now imagine that scene. Masrana charanapatam. They have to tell her. See, that is something which is common for people, for commoners. It's very natural when you see stones, even children who are used to walking on stone, they will immediately tiptoe on those places or try to place them softly. If you place it hardly, your foot is going to hurt. So even children know that they have to do. But she was being brought up in the palace, and from one palace she has gone to another palace. So there is no prasaktireva nasti tasyaha etadrishyam bhumyam gantum. So masrana charanapatam gamyatam bhusadarpa. Next, murdhni gharmaha katoraha. The sun is really gharmaha. The heat is katoraha. It is very very enna solradhu terrible on your head. Murdhni gharmaha kathoraha asti sichayantam virachaya. Sichayantam, sichayam ityukte avshukam, uttaravastram, pallu that you have, please put it on your head. They have to say that to her. The situation, see, that is why Janakaputri fits so beautifully. It's such an auchitya purna shlokam. I don't even feel like saying one dosham in this. Masrana charanapadam gamyatam bhusadarbha. Virachaya sijayantam murdhri gharmaha katoraha. Gharmaha, the heat is so katoram, terrible. Murdhni sijayantam virachaya. So take your sari and just cover your head a little bit. So tasmat karanat, that tat, again you have to take it from the dhityartham and put it there. So murdhri gharmaha katoraha tat tasmat karanat sichayantam virachaya. So place your pallu on top of your head so that it doesn't heat up your you don't feel the discomfort. Iti janakaputri ashrupurnaihi lochanaihi. Why won't they feel that? It will tear up. Ashrupurnaihi lochanaihi pathika vadubihi pathi vikshita, because they see the way she is behaving. You know, she doesn't know to behave like this. She doesn't know how to walk on this earth. She doesn't know that the heat is heavy. She will only feel that uncomfort. You know, when a child encounters something new, it wouldn't know the reason for it. It will only know its suffering. The same way, Sita is practically a child in all this. She only knew her suffering. She just realizes that she's feeling uncomfortable, but she probably doesn't know because it's of inexperience. Ananubhuta purvatvat. So, patika vadu vihi shikshita cha. So, they advise her on what to do. Masrina charanavadam gamyatam bhut sadarbhas. It's a beautiful shloka. Okay, then, the As you know, every time to explain the first half, we had to take that one particular word got caught in the second half. And so that tat kept on, we had to lift it from the second half and put it in the first half to get the artha. Okay, so that is the dosham here. I hope you understood the dosham. Let's move to the next one. Next one is it Abhavan Mata Yogam? Okay. So next one is Abhavan Mata Yoga Abhavan Mata Sambandha or Abhavan Mata Yoga is the next dosha. So Abhavan Mataha Ishtaha Yoga Sambandha Yatra Tat Yatha. Okay. So before we go into this, let me give a small explanation about this. So Abhavan na bhavati iti abhavan avidyamanaha ityarthaha. So avidyamanaha mataha abhimataha ishtaha ishtaha yogaha yatra na vidyate yasmin vakye na vidyate tad vakyam abhavan mata yoga dosha yuktam asti. So what does that mean? Yatra abhimataha yogaha na vidyate, where the vivakshita sambandha na vidyate. It is very difficult to understand the meaning. Padartha yoho anvayaha eva yatra na sambhavati tad abhavan mata yoga. So if it can get, you can get confused with avimrishta videyamsaha and abhavan mata yogyatvam. The difference being here padartha yoho anvayaha na sambhavati. There is only a problem with the udeshya videya bhavam. Udeshya videya bhavam, the meaning is understood. There is no problem. Padarthayoho anvayaha sambhavati. Parantu atra padarthayoho anvayaha eva na sambhavati. That is abhavan mata yogatvam. Whereas avimrishta videyamsham is just that it depends on the problem between the udeshyamsha and the videyamsha. Here, that is not the issue. Because why I'm stressing that is the first problem you will notice is it will be very similar to Avivrishta Videyamsham, where the Udeshyamsha has a different vibhakti, the Videyamsha has a different vibhakti, or then you will say that there is no difference between Avivrishta Videyamsham and Abhavan Mata Yoga. Here itself, I will clarify the Padartha Yoho Eva Anvayaha Asambhavaha, Parantu Avimrishta Videyamsha, Padartha Yoho Anvayaha Sambhavati. Udeshya Videyamsha and the Anvayaha between the Udeshyamsha and the Videyamsha is a problem there. This dosha can occur in six ways. One is Vibhakti-bheda-nibandhanam, Nyunatadi-nibandhanam. Two, third one is Akanksha-viraha-nibandhanam. Fourth one is Vachya-vyangyayoho Vivakshita-yoga-abhava-nibandhanam. Fourth is Samasachchannataya-matayoga-abhava-nibandhanam. Sixth is Vyutpatti Virodha Nibandhanam. Each one he is going to give an example for each of those. The first one is Vibhakti Bheda Nibandhana. Yeshamtaha Tridashebha Dana Saritaha Pitaha Pratapushma Bihi Leelapana Bhuvascha Nandanavana Chhayasu Yaih Kalpitaha Yesham Hunkritayaha Kritamarapati Kshobhaha Kshapacharinam Kim Taihi Tvat Paritoshakari vihitam kinchit pravadochitam. I think this is also Balaramayanam, or I don't think it is Balaramayanam, but it is the context here he gives. 1 minute, let me look at that context. It's a very nice context. Hanumata Lankayam Dagdhayam. हनुमता लंकायां दग्धायां वीर राक्षसान अधिक्षिपतः कस्यचित् रावणं प्रति उक्तिः. He doesn't give the text or anything for this. So Hanuman has arrived in Lanka and his tail has been set on fire. Now he has gone and he is now burning the entire Lanka. So Hanumata Lankayam Dagdayam Satyam. At that point of time, someone, Kasyachit Uktihi Ayam, what is he saying? Veera Rakshasana Adhikshipataha. He is censuring, he is saying, what are all your Rakshasas doing? You know, I have heard so many things about your Rakshasas. Someone is telling Ravana about this. He says, Yesham, Yesham Kshapacharinam, Kshapayam Charati iti Kshapachari Nishacharaha Rakshasaha. So Rakshasam Pratapa Ushmabihi. I have heard about their valor, and that valor, Pratapa, is like Tejas. So he is comparing to by saying that Pratapa is hot and Prasada is cool. So showing your valor is creating an Ushma, a heat. Showing your grace is like a cool breeze. So that is your Kavi Samayam. So here, Yesham Rakshasanam Pratapa Ushmabihi, Pratapa, by the heat of their Pratapa valor, they have dried up the Tridasha Ibha Dana Saritaha Pitaha. All those, the heat has dried up the Dana Jalam, you know, the Mada Jala that comes from the elephants of the Tridasha, the Devas. The Deva elephants, Devanam Gajanam Mada Jala, Mada Jalam Yeva Sarit. Tatha Vidanam Saritanam Panam Kritam. Gajai, sorry, Pratapa Ushmabihi. So, Pitaha, Pratapa Ushmabihi, Saritaha, Pitaha. Those rivers, the ikhar or that madajalam of the divine elephants that flow like rivers, they have all Pitaha. They have drunk that with their Pratapa Ushma. Drunk means they've dried up. In the sense, the divine elephants cannot show their valor today. They have been defeated by the asuras. That is Ravana's Arasura. So those Rakshasas who are famed to have defeated those elephants. Next, what have they done? Yaihi cha, yaihi kshapachari bihi, lilapana bhuvaha kritaha kalpitaha, kutra nandanavana chayasu lilapana bhuvaha kalpitaha. If you remember in your first year Neelakanta Vijayachampu, where Amaravati, when it was taken over by the Asuras, they had made all those suburbs had become panagraham. Madira Griham. So that's what he's saying here. Nandanavana Chayasu, in the shadows of that Nandanavana, Indra's garden, have all been, liquor places have been created. Leela Pana Bhubaha Kalpitaha Yehi. By whom those the bars have been created in those in the Nandanavana, in the Udyana. Yesham Kshapacharinam Cha Humkritayaha. Their sound, hunkriti. Hunkriti is ahankarena yaha shabdaha kriyate, yagdhvanihi kriyate, saha hunkriti, saha hunkriti, whichever. So, yesham kshapacharinam hunkritayaha, krita amarapati kshobhaha. By hearing that hunkriti of those rakshasa, amarapati, Indra just starts trembling. He feels very agitated by hearing that noise. Amarapati, amarapati kshobhaha kritaha. Yaihi humkritibihi. No, kim taihi rakshasaihi tvat paritoshakari pravada uchitam tvat paritoshakari kinchit vihitam kim. So someone is questioning Ravana. No, pravada uchitam. All these rumors that I have said, you know, they have apparently, the moment these Rakshasas make a sound, Indra in his Simhasana will just start shaking. I've heard that. Now, pravada uchitam, appropriate to that rumor, that story, tvatparitoshakari cha, something which gives you happiness, kimapi vihitam kim, kinchitapi vihitam kim. Have they performed anything that gives you happiness or that is true to the stories that are roaming around about them? This Hanuman, this monkey has set fire to the entire Lanka. Now, what have your Rakshasas achieved? Nothing, right? So, they have, someone is complaining to Ravana, actually ridiculing the Rakshasas to him. Okay. Now, this is a little bit tough to understand. Takes a long time. So, Atra, Gunanam cha paratvat, asambandaha, samatvat, syat, iti uttanayena, yachabda nirdeshyanam arthanam, parasparam, asamanvayena, yaihi, ityatra, visheshasya apratitihi, iti, kshapacharibihi, iti pathe, युज्यते समन्वयः. देर् इस् अ पाठान्तरं वेर् यु केन् से येषां हुं कृतयः कृतामरपति क्षोभाः क्षपाचारिभिः. द मीटर् विल् आल्सो बि फैन्, देर् विल् बि नो इश्यूस् वित् दट् इन्स्टेड् आफ् क्षपाचारिणा. इफ् वि यूस् द पाठभेदं, दीस् आर् आल् क्लूस्, दीस् दोषास् आर् आल्सो क्लूस् फार् अस् टु फिक्स् द रीडिङ्ग् इन् texts that we find, in manuscripts that we find. How do we fix the reading, which is the correct reading? These are all the clues that which give us. So to avoid dosha, he is a Mahakavi, he cannot be making such doshas. So you, if you find a better reading, then you adopt that reading. If you have 10 manuscripts of one work, say Shakuntalam or even Malavikaagnimitram or something, you know, or a new kavi whom you know is a Mahakavi or is a great scholar who has proved himself in grammar or nyaya, and you suddenly come up with a work of his, you have 4 or 5 manuscripts. So the reading in 4 manuscripts are Kshapacharina. Only one manuscript has a reading Kshapacharibihi. Given that he is a grammar expert and given that he is a Mimamsa expert, you will assume that he will know these rules and he would not have used Kshapacharinam, he would have only used Kshapacharibihi, even though only one manuscript gives you that idea. You will have to take that based on the fact that it avoids a dosha like this. Now, what is the dosha here? Before I explain that Mimamsa Nyayam, let's look at how the shlokam is arranged. So you have Uddeshyamsha and the Videyamsha. I'm using Uddeshyamsha, Videyamsha in my terminology so that it is easier to understand. Do not confuse with Avimrishta Videyamsha. So, Yesham Pratapa Ushmabihi Pitaha. That is one. The next Uddeshyamsha is Yaihi Panabhuvaha Kalpitaha. This third one is Yesham Hunkratayaha. Now, everything is going to be connected with the Tatshabdamsham, which is Taihi kim vihitam, kinchitu vihitam kim. Okay, now how is it arranged? Each one you'll have to take it separately, and then you will see that yesham kshapacharinam pitaha to ushmabihi pitaha taihi kim vihitam, that fits properly, so there is no problem there. Next is yesham kshapacharinam hum krutayaha amarapati kshobaha krutaha taihi kim vihitam, that also fits properly, no issues. Now this yaihi kalpitaha taihi, now this is where the problem lies, where you have the visheshyam as kshapacharinam. The visheshyam that you give for them is yaihi kalpitaha taihi vihitam. If we had kshapacharibihi, then there is no problem. So, yaihi kshapacharinam won't fit. So, yaihi kshapacharinam, both are vibhakti bhedam. One is in tritiya vibhakti, the other is in shashti bahuvachanam. So, that won't fit. So, you can't have the expression as yaihi kshapacharinam and taihi vihitam. At the same time, if you want to put this kshapacharinam in the tatshabdamsha, there also, yaihi kalpitaha taihi kshapacharinam. Where will you fit that? That again will also have a vibhakti bhedaha. So both of these are not possible. Whereas when you go to the Pathantaram, when it is kshapacharibihi, I can include that with the tatshabdamsha and say, yesham pitaha, yesham ushmabihi pitaha, yaihi kalpitaha yesham hunkratayaha kshobaha krutaha taihi kshapacharibihi vihitametate. Then that would fit perfectly with this. Now all of this fits the why this dosha even arises. He gives a nyayam for that and justifies it from Mimamsa Nyaya. The Mimamsa Nyaya is gunanam cha pararthatvat sambandhaha samatvat syat. How to understand that? Guna. Guna means apradhanam. There are many meanings for gunam. Each shastra has its own separate meaning. Even within the shastra, we take the context and fix the meaning of guna. Here, गुण इत्युक्ते अप्रधानम्, सो गुणानाम् अप्रधानानां विशेषणानाम् अथवा ओके यू केन् टेक् इट् एस् विशेषण, यू केन् टेक् इट् एस् अप्रधानम्. सो गुणानां परार्थत्वात् दट् इस् द फस्ट् आस्पेक्ट्, दट् इस् द फस्ट् पार्ट् आफ् दट् न्यायम्. सो वाट् इस् दट् न्यायम् मीन् गुणानां परार्थत्वात्, गुणानाम् अप्रधानानां विशेषणानां च परार्थत्वात् पर अर्थत्वात् परार्थ अन्वय अपेक्षत्वात् प्रधानार्थ अन्वय अपेक्षत्वात् वेन् ऐ हाव् अ विशेषण इट् एक्स्पेक्ट् प्रधानार्थ, द सेकेण्डरी आल्वेस् एक्स्पेक्ट्स् अ प्रैमरी फार् इट्स् अन्वयम्. सो इफ् ऐ हाव् यच्छब्दांश यच्छब्देन निर्दिश्यमानानाम् अर्थानां that is only the gunarthanam. So gunanam ityukte yachabdena nirdishyamananam arthanam, shloke yachabdena yaha arthaha ye arthaha nirdishyante. So that parasparam they cannot have an anvaya between themselves, that is the second part. They all expect parartha, which is tajabdamtam apekshate. The second part of that nyayam is asambandaha samatvad. What does that mean? Asambandha. Asambandha ityukte gunanam parasparam anvayasya asambandhatvat. Anvayasya asambhavah. So the apradhanam or the visheshanas that are there, they have no means to be connected towards each other. I can't say yaha gunaman, yaha shrutaman, yaha vidyavan. I cannot put a full stop there. It expects a pradhanartha. सः किं भवति, सः कः, सः किं करोति, यु एक्स्पेक्ट् समथिङ्ग्, यु आर् यु आर् वेटिङ्ग् फार् दि आन्सर् देर् रैट्. सो दे केनाट् दोस् इफ् ऐ जस्ट् से यः श्रुतवान्, यः गुणज्ञः, यः मतिमान्, इट् विल् नाट् कम्बैन् वित् ईच् अदर्. परस्परम् अनन्वयः, परस्परम् असम्बन्धः. वै? समत्वात् दे आर् ईक्वल् इन् द फ्याक्ट् देट् दे एक्स्पेक्ट् अ परार्थ. पर अपेक्षायाः निरत नियतत्वात् दट् इस् ओन्ली दट् इस् द कन्क्लूशन् देर्. समत्वात् मीनिङ्ग् ईक्वल्, बिकास् दे आर् ईक्वल् दे केनाट् बि कम्बैन् टुगेदर्, दे केनाट् हेव् अ रिलेशन्शिप् बिट्वीन् ईच् अदर्. दे एक्स्पेक्ट् अनदर् थिङ्ग्. सो प्रधानस्य अपेक्षायां समानत्वात् दे केन् ओन्लि बि कनेक्टेड् वित् द प्रैमरी थिङ्ग्. जस्ट् लैक् हौ अ वील् you have as parts of something, anga, so that is the avayava, avayavibhava. There is a fruit, there is flower, there is branch, there is leaf, everything is present. But everything needs a tree to exist. All of these are parts of the avayavi. It needs that primary thing. So the visheshanas, all of the visheshanas, if I say neelaha, shvetaha, chitravarnaha, and all of those visheshanas are equal to each other, and hence they do not have a parasparam anvayam. They are equal in the fact that they expect a pradhana. Pradhanasya apekshayam samanatvat, that is what he means by samatvat. Now let's go back to the vritti. Atra गुणानां च परत्वात् कम असम्बन्धः समत्वात् स्यात् इति उक्तनयेन मीमांसैः मीमांसकारैः उक्तनयेन यच्छब्दनिर्देश्यानाम् अर्थानां परस्परम् असमन्वयेन दे केनाट् कनेक्ट् वित् ईच् अदर् रैट्. दट् इस् वै ईवन् इफ् ऐ से येषां ऊष्मभिः पीताः यैः कल्पिताः येषां हूं कृतयः एवं भवन्ति क्षोभाः भवन्ति इट् एक्स्पेक्ट्स्. सो यु नीड् अनदर् थिङ्ग् दट् इस् युर् क्षपाचारिणां. दट् क्षपाचारिणां केनाट् कम्बैन् वित् देर् इस् नो तेषाम् इन् द तत् शब्दांश फार् इट् टु कनेक्ट्. सो यु शुड् ऐदर् हेव् मेड् येषां कल्पिताः आर् इवन् इफ् इट् इस् इफ् इट् वास् क्षपाचारिभिः देन् इट् इस् फैन् ओके. स यैः इत्यत्र विशेषस्य अप्रतीतिः, देर् इस् नो there is no particularity, just like how in Navavayo, Lasyaya, Venuswanaha, if there is a particularity, special attention that I want you to show to this, that is why I have given it like this. There is no such speciality also associated by making it yaihi. It only shows that the kavi is not ashaktitvat. Avyatpattikritaha doshaha or ashaktikritaha doshaha. There are only two types of dosha. The poet is unable to make it, probably. That is why I talked about that manuscript and fixing the reading and all that. So, kshapacharivihi iti patetu samanvayaha yujyate eva. Is it clear? We'll stop with this. Any doubt? Sure. Okay. Namaste.
Yeah.